right? That people do not read talk descriptions. So, if you think this is a technical talk in any way, you're more than welcome to leave, because there's nothing really technical that I'm going to share with you. We're not going to open the dashboard. There's just nothing good. This is all just how to find work. What kind of jobs are out there? So this is me when I'm wearing my sunglasses. You can find out more about me on my website, and I'm fairly active on Twitter. So today, we're going to take a look at what does a career in WordPress look like, and why do it anyway? And then we're going to talk about what are current career trends beyond development and design, and where do you find work, and what can help you get hired. So let's start with, what does a career in WordPress look like? Because careers in WordPress are not your grandparents' careers. They're not even really your parents' careers. I was talking with a friend who is a high-level senior developer. Like, he's the most senior developer I may know, and I know some very senior developers. He's been at his current job for 5 years. For me, 5 years seems like no time at all. You know, you think of someone being in a job for 25 years, 30 years, retiring from a single job. Now in WordPress, after 5 years, even though he loves his job, he's starting to wonder if he needs to move on simply so he continues to look relevant. He is absolutely relevant. He could get a job anywhere. And he loves where he works, but is still wondering if he needs to move on. So we'll take a look at my husband's 10 years in WordPress. He started in 2009 as a corporate developer. He worked for a university for 10 years, 2010. 2010, we went freelance. 2011, one of our freelancing clients became our first startup. The first startup ended abruptly, and we ended up with a VIP agency. Then we, as the owner of the VIP agency came to my husband and said, hey, I have this idea. And what was originally going to be a business turned into a nonprofit called HeroWorks. But when he went on to try this idea, they filled his position. He knew this would happen. So he then had to find another job, and he ended up in a plug-in shop. He was at the plug-in shop for about a year and a half, and he went to a VIP agency again. He was at the VIP agency for about 4 months. And then he did a startup, or he did a partnership. And anytime you're starting a business, you might as well call it another startup. That ended fairly abruptly after about a year, and we found ourselves unish employed, or as I like to call it, differently employed, for about 6 months. Because if you're a contractor, you're never completely without work. But if you're looking to hire on with somebody else, it's really difficult to build your freelancing career and still go through the trials that are necessary to work for someone else. So that was an interesting time of life. And then in 2018, the second half of 2018, he started working for a non-WordPress e-commerce company, and he's been there for about a year and a half, or a year. And he looks like it's going to stick for a while, which I'm really delighted about. So as you can see, in a minute, you'll see. WordPress, for all that he was working in WordPress for 10 years, because it's so easy to come up with ideas, it's so easy to just try something, there can be a lot of like hopping around or just moving from one thing to the next until you kind of find the place that fits you best. Does this mean that your career path is going to look like this? Like I said, my friend's been at his job for 5 years. No. But it does mean it could look like this. And not only is it not unusual, it doesn't make you look bad to have moved between different jobs, depending on why and how. So, if WordPress can be so chaotic, why would you choose it anyway? I made the choice, instead of going back to school for my master's degree, WordPress is very flexible. It has an amazing community that you can choose to be a part of. And because it's an open source platform, it is always growing and changing. And if you choose, you can be a part of the growth and change. WordPress can become whatever you want it to be. In fact, if you would like, you can go in, copy all of the WordPress code, and create your own TimPress. And you can start your own WordPress community, or TimPress community, as it were. So if you're interested in getting involved in WordPress, and you're coming at it kind of like I am, where you know about WordPress, but you're not really sure how to start working in it, you need to look at three things. You really have to evaluate what impacts your life. What are the outside factors that make up your life? You need to look at, so do you have children at home? Are you trying to work around taking care of your children? Are you a caregiver to anybody else? You need to think about that. Even having pets can have a big difference. Then examine what makes you unique. We each have something, some inherent skills that we can bring to the community. It doesn't matter if we're all designers, we're all going to design from a different perspective because we all have our own history. And then once you decide, you know, what things impact your life and what makes you unique, you need to test your conclusions. You know, get out into the community, start having conversations with people, and find out if the things that you think make you a unique individual, make you an asset in an area, are actually things that other people find make you an asset in that area. And again, we're evaluating what impacts your life. Who depends on you? What are your healthcare needs? Do you need a team? These are three really important questions when you're looking at what impacts your life. Like I covered who depends on you. Healthcare is something that people don't always think about. If you're coming from a job that is already providing healthcare for you, and you're looking at possibly freelancing, the cost of healthcare can be astounding. It makes it really difficult to let kids take up skateboarding because you cannot handle the cost of an ER visit. So healthcare is really an important one. If you have a chronic disease, you really need to think about what job you're going to take based on those kind of needs. And then, do you need a team? I just made a friend, who's working for, she was not a WordPress person. She worked in an office of about 200 people, recently just joined a WordPress company that is fully distributed, and she really missed having a water cooler where she could talk to people. She really missed getting up and moving around. She's enjoying working from home, but she didn't necessarily think about the impact that not being in an office full of people was going to have. You don't always have to be in an office full of people to have a team, but there are a lot of WordPress companies where you're given individual tasks and you work on them individually and maybe come together at different stages to present what you've done, but you're never actually working with another person. That's a really big need. So when you're examining what makes you unique, think about what you can already do. What are things that you are currently good at? What are things you currently enjoy? What do you have training in already? And then think about what do you like to do? I mean, if you're creating a job for yourself or you're making a change, don't move into something you don't like doing. Even if it's a necessary aspect of the job you're looking to choose, think about ways then that you can outsource it, people you can hire to do it. And always be honest with yourself. Don't pretend that you know more than you do. Don't pretend that you like something just because you think that you should or because people are hiring for it. If it doesn't fit you well, you're not going to have a positive experience. And then last, when you're testing your conclusions, examine your own experience. What needs have you seen in the community? When I started my approach, I looked at the 20 years I'd spent alongside my husband and thought, to their feedback on what your ideas are. It's the more you talk to people, the bigger your net is of people looking, like the ideas that can come to you, as well as the perspectives they can give you that help you see problems that you may not have understood at first. In the end, you need to figure out what matters most. Do you want a flexible lifestyle? Do you care? Like, do you need to make a certain amount of money because that's what your bills are? That's what your financial goals are. Do you want to live in a specific place, or do you want to not be tied to a specific place? Figure out what things matter, or what one thing matters the most, and use it as your deciding factor, your coin flip, as it were. Like, what are your what things are you going to be inflexible about? So now that you've thought through what you might want to do, one of the biggest questions is, should you freelance? Should you work for yourself, or should you work for someone else? And I really love this picture, because even though I can't see behind the tree, I have the idea that the path really doesn't split into two paths. It just goes around the tree and comes back together. So many people in the WordPress community go in and out of freelancing. And often, freelancing will lead you to your next company. They'll see that you're good in this area, and maybe someone will reach out to hire you. And then you'll have this great idea, and you'll find yourself back freelancing again. It's not uncommon. But what should you think about if you're going to freelance? First off, when do you make change? My husband had a job for 10 years. He had a job that he would never get fired from. The economy tanked. They started working more hours with fewer people, with fewer benefits. And ironically, as the economy tanked, website demand went up because people who hadn't had jobs or were looking for new sources of income actually needed more websites. And so for us, the demand for work rose to the point where we had enough hours at either place, and we could choose to work for ourselves instead of for a place where we felt undercompensated, overworked. He didn't feel challenged, and for us, the work was there. So some of the benefits of working for yourself are that you have a flexible schedule. You get to decide as much as you want to what your day looks like. Flexible location, that can mean working from home, that can mean working from a co-working space. You get to decide. It can mean from working on the beach in Aruba. It just depends on what you want to do. You also get to choose your clients as much as you want to. Obviously, the broader your choice of clients, the more work you have available, the narrower the choice. You know, it just depends on what you're looking for. And then finally, if you work for yourself, you have the potential of being more available to other people in your life. Again, some of these things are choices. If you set up good boundaries, you can have these things. If you set up bad boundaries, you'll find yourself working for yourself and still not have these boundaries. Some of the benefits of working for someone else are you can be part of a team. And again, that doesn't always happen. You aren't automatically on a team where you're interacting with coworkers every day. But the potential is there, and you can look for that in the agency or the company that you're hiring on with. Often when you work for someone else, you can focus on one role. As a freelancer, you have to do your marketing, you have to do your payroll, you have to do all these things that are not just building a website or writing content. Where if you work for someone else, you have more potential to do a narrower scope of work. You also have combined resources. You've got the perspectives of others, you've got combined physical resources, you get the experience of the other people that you're working with. There's a lot that can come from that. You also can have shared responsibilities. If you are sick, someone can pick up your work. If you want to go on vacation, there isn't necessarily a huge pile waiting for you when you get back. And again, you don't have to be good at everything. If you're good in one area, changed its rates. It makes a lot of things like insurance and taxes and all the necessary governmental things just so much easier. Regardless of whether you choose to work for yourself or work for someone else, stepping out into a new environment, there will be obstacles. You need to anticipate challenges. Things are not going to go exactly the way you expected. You're going to hire into a company and find that the role you thought you were hiring on for was not the role that they thought you were hiring on for. You might find that working at home is more difficult for you, or working remotely. There are any number of challenges that can pop up. Just know that they will be there. Don't be intimidated by those with experience. I like to think of them as giants. For me, it has been really difficult to step into WordPress because everybody I know has been doing it for 20 years. They have businesses and they have portfolios and they have, you know, just this long history that I don't have. But what I've found is they're really happy to help me get started, help me to figure out my history, or get started on my history, help me to find jobs that fit me, provide encouragement, help me learn from their mistakes. So for all that there might be giants, they're very friendly, helpful giants. And then setbacks are unavoidable. One of my biggest constants in talking to anybody about how they got started on their business, how they got started in their new jobs, any of that, there are always setbacks. There are things that you don't know, can't know until you're in the middle of it. There are technology issues. There just are any number of setbacks that are going to happen. Just know that that's normal. Everybody experiences that. So, now that we've taken a look at all of that, let's look at what some of the current job trends are. And this is looking beyond development and design. I mean, it's great if you want to be a developer, and it's great if you want to be a designer. And there are actually quite a lot of jobs, it seems, for particularly junior-level designers, or junior-level developers at the moment. But I knew going in, I didn't want to be a developer or a designer. So what else can you do? You can create things for other people. So developers and designers need things on their websites. They need content. They need creative content. Sometimes they need blog posts written. Sometimes developers need technical content. It can be how-tos for plugins or a service they provide. But technical content is becoming a real asset to support. And then expository is more of a journalistic style of writing. So whether you're kind of a real world sort of thing, and again, that's more for content on a website. Maybe you help with writing the actual content for a website. And then editing. I'm learning. I like editing more than I like content creation. I like to maintain the voice of the person whose company I'm working for. I like to make other people look good. I like to help other people learn how to write better, and editing can do that. There's also, when you're creating for others, the need for SEO. You can implement SEO practices. You can audit websites for SEO. And then there's different areas of specialization as you start to get into things like statistics. When you're creating for others, you can also get involved in strategy, whether it's an SEO strategy or a content strategy. Same thing with auditing. And then podcasting, video, and photography. There's a big need for quality photographs, whether it's headshots for staff pages or just unique photography on websites. So these are all options. And then here's a look at those six things. Another area that you can work without being a developer and designer is promoting for others. community engagement. All of these areas, the jobs are out there if you start looking for them. Community engagement can be anything from having conversations with people at a booth, like you saw today, or it can be working more one-on-one with clients that already exist. Social media management is becoming a much bigger issue as people know they need social media, but they really don't want the hassle of having to deal with social media. And then marketing can fall in a ton of different areas. And then there are ways to help others. You can do it through administration. People are finding that they had, for instance, a successful plugin. They were a developer, they built a plugin, it became a success. Now they've got payroll, they've got employees, they need human resources help, they've got taxes that have to be paid. They're running a business that they never intended to run, so they need people to come in and help with those sorts of jobs. And again, business management. Business management can be different from administration in that you can come alongside a developer who's or a creative person and help them by taking care of the business side, which then allows them to open up their time for more creative pursuits. Project management is becoming very big, and then I just recently saw a job posting for product management. Both of those are being the bridge between the client and the developer or your creative staff. Project management is working obviously on the thing that you're building. Product management is helping to discover what new products would fit that company and then helping them get to the market. And then support, I have in green, I have it in capitals, everybody's hiring for support right now. If you have technical skills, and you like to help people, and you can communicate in any way, you should be able to find a job in support. It's a great way to use new technical knowledge that you might have, or say you have a favorite plugin, a favorite product. More than likely, they are looking for support help, and the thing they really need is those customer service skills. One of the other things you can do is join a non-WordPress business. WordPress is up to 33% of the internet. That means that there are tons of companies out there that are using WordPress and often have no idea. The company my husband hired onto recently had no idea how the WordPress community worked. And we all know that the community is a really big part of WordPress. So companies are hiring WordPress people, even if they're not a WordPress business or exclusively a WordPress business, to help them manage their website, to help them understand the community better, to help them just be more productive in that ecosystem. And then you can always start something new. If you have an idea that doesn't fit into any of those categories, if you've looked at your skills and you've thought about what you enjoy doing, and it's none of those things, but you see a need for it, you had a conversation, you've heard other people's pain points, then look into trying to start something new. You have no idea where it'll take you, but if you see the need for it, chances are good that with the right marketing and the right conversations, you can be a success at it. So here's a list of all of those 11 things. You can work in content, which can be SEO, marketing, social media, community engagement, administration, business management, project management, support, non-WordPress business, and start your own thing. But at the same time, don't give up on development or design. Maybe you had a bad experience, maybe it wasn't the right time for you to take that experiences. You know that this is a viable job. You participated in the community, so you know that there's a need for it. And you've had conversations with people so that they're not only giving you feedback about the value of your idea, but they're also now helping you look for ideas. And this can be anybody inside the community or outside the community. Let your friends know what you're trying to start. Let your parents know. You know, everybody can be helping you with resources, funneling them towards you. Here are some tools you can use. These are the places you can go to try to find work. LinkedIn seems to be coming back. I thought it was dying, but it seems that it's on an upswing. Codable and Upwork are both sites you can go to find work in technology. Networking is huge. Twitter, WordCamps, a lot of WordCamps have job boards. There's getting out, having conversations, talking to people is one of your greatest assets. And then there's also Slack channels that you can sign up for where you can continue having the conversations and they can spread beyond who you meet in person and you can talk to people all over the world. So here are some tips on getting the gig. Getting hired in WordPress can be a little different than getting hired at an average corporate job. In WordPress, often your skills will trump your education. So it doesn't matter necessarily if you have a degree or if your degree is in the thing that you're hiring on for. If you show a proficiency for the skills, are trainable, have an interest, then chances